The princess was pierced by 80 spears through her body. In the moment when the spears were pulled out, he realized how foolish he had been all along. The husband he had relied on turned out to be using him as a pawn. The general, whom he had never taken seriously, lost his life for his sake. However, it was only when the girl opened her eyes that she discovered she had actually gone back to the day before her wedding, getting a second chance at life. Determined to make the scoundrel and the despicable woman pay a heavy price, the girl is set on seeking revenge.
司统领，这确实是我们的家务事。公主已经嫁入萧家，就是萧家的儿媳妇。何况，她残害我萧府侧夫人腹中的胎儿在先。
在结果出来之前，先不要往下定论，还是等太医诊断之后再来定夺。
雪儿已经被他丢进湖中，已经小产，现在还在床上躺着。他身边的侍女都看见了，这难道还不能定夺吗？
难道要听他的吗？一个以色侍人的妾室，如果被证实是故意陷害公主，就该直接溺毙在湖里。
司桑，你可信我？
信。
好，
你们都给本宫听好，司统领在此作证，稍后太医诊断，侧夫人如若真是萧产，那本宫便交由萧家处置，绝无怨言。但如若萧家和侧夫人一起污蔑本宫，让本宫承受如此冤罪，本宫便要休了萧公子，从此与萧家恩断义绝，势不两立。
妾室也许假装小产，萧家将我扣上草菅人命的罪名，被世人唾弃，从此断了争夺皇位的可能。今世我定不能让他们如愿。
简直荒谬！
公主所提的要求，萧家一定会答应。